Hi friends, this is Luis. I made my pilgrimage to Santiago and now I'm back from Spain in the US at home. It was a great experience. I did not blog or share it because to me it would have gone against the spirit of the pilgrimage. Besides, I'm trying to cut down a little bit on my social media addiction anyway. But now I want to share with you something very important. It's about the most popular myth you will hear about El Camino de Santiago. And you probably never heard about it. But before that, for the ones that don't know what El Camino de Santiago is, which means the way of James, the James Path, let me tell you what it is. It is a Christian path created approximately in 800 AC. When the body of the Apostle James, Santiago in Spanish, was found in northwest Spain. And from then on, many paths to his burial were created. People came from all over the continent that now we call Europe. It was the Christian world until fairly recently. And the practice they followed was to walk in prayer or even penance with very little, giving alms, if possible, along the way to the burial of the apostle. There, they would worship close to the burial. Fast forward now to 2022. Now it's a safer path with all kinds of services here and there along the way and a lot of support. So much so that it has become a very popular alternative tourist vacation for people around the world. Most don't have religious interest. And according to official statistics, in 2021, only 36% claim religious reasons for doing it. The rest, at best, will claim a generic spiritual reasons. And for what I've read, especially from my conversations with lots of them in the path, the most popular myth that pilgrims there hold goes something like this. We each make our own path. It's not about El Camino, the path, but all about our own Camino. Now, you're perhaps nodding yes with that quote and think me crazy to hint at challenging it. But hear me out with an open mind. In the end, I think you will understand what I'm saying and it will enhance your experience of walking there, if you are considering it. In one way, we do our own path. Our subjectivity is important to the experience. We need to have enough of it to do it. The better grasp on who you are, the more meaningful the experience. Yes, that is partly true, but the problem, like many lies that hide behind some truth, is that goes on to suppress everything else around it, especially El Camino itself, its history, its meaning, and its gifts. Now, tell me, doesn't it sound strange to have somebody walking on one of the highest Catholic practices throughout history while making the claim that has nothing to do with that, but it's just all about myself? Allow me to offer you this example that I hope will make clear what I'm saying. Suppose that years down the road, the pilgrimage to La Mecca that any Muslim is required to do is available to anybody regardless of faith. You can switch here La Mecca for the Western world and Muslim for Jewish, and it will work the same. Now suppose that any person can be a pilgrim through little towns of Muslim tradition and history, going back centuries, seeing local mosques, shrines along the way. So they would be going around the Arab world all the way to the big black stone in La Mecca and to go around it and then participate in a ceremony presided by the Ayatollah for him and all the pilgrims. Now, if that pilgrim were to tell you, I did it only about me. It's all about me and my path. Wouldn't that sound strange? Wouldn't you feel like telling him, wait, you are heavily embedding yourself in a Muslim tradition and ritual, benefiting from it, but then you claim that it's all about you? You know how weird that sounds? That is what I'm talking about. our It's All About Me pilgrim in Spain goes through a practice that many in Western humanity have gone through for centuries. Whatever and however they did it back then, it allowed them to build all the paths, hospitals, lodges, bridges, churches, cities, towns that the present pilgrim now enjoys. And they did it back then feeling included and closer to a higher meaning. But the present pilgrim goes around with the myth, claiming to be outside of it, and is confining himself. If you want to amplify the effect that causes, just multiply the guy by the thousands, crowding La Mecca, going around the Black Stone, taking selfies, while a minority of Muslims are trying to worship. You see the problem? Today in Santiago, few have any idea or respect for the tradition they have traveled upon and benefit from. While Mass happens in the Cathedral of Santiago, for example, it is packed with people taking pics with their cell phones. What I want to address here are the personal, spiritual consequences that traveling with that myth can have on you. Whoever travels with that myth will probably go there and back with his ego intact. No cracks on it. Just an improved version and plenty of pics and nice experience with nature and with people. For instance, I met a guy there that walked all the way from the Pyrenees. His answer to my standard question, "Why are you doing this?" was, "I want to diminish my ego." And I thought, wonderful, yeah. But then he added, right after that, "Because I realize it's all inside me." But I don't think he knew what he was saying, or that he realized that those sentences were canceling each other. In the first, he expresses his desire to put aside his ego. In the next one, he erects a castle and thrones the ego in it. It's all about me. I don't know what he got out of the path in the end. I didn't know him from before. Probably he got lots of good things anyway, since it is a very generous ritual and path. But I can say that in the rest of our conversations, he made clear that all externalities were illusory and only his self was real and king. And I know that I talked with many, many pilgrims there, and most held that myth one way or another. There's a scene actually in the life of Brian where the followers of Brian keep echoing back to him in unison, "We are all individuals." It is hard to talk about these things, so perhaps translating an excerpt from this book, the best I've found about it, could help. It is very well written. It's called Catholic Guide for El Camino de Santiago by José Antonio Ulate Fabo. It's not in English, unfortunately, so I'm translating this for you. He says, "Although it is true that we make the path by walking it, we cannot use that to cancel the very existence of El Camino. That is the abuse. We could say that El Camino is the essence or nature of the pilgrimage, and that our walking is the act of being. We cannot think of existence without the essence, and vice versa. In the real thing, there is no essence without its existence. The Catholic person who is under this weakness of thought that empties El Camino of its own recognizable features reduces the influence of his faith over the pilgrimage to a mere subjective motivation, his own exclusively, without considering the rest of motivations outside of himself. If El Camino exists beyond the marvelous catalyzer of the thousand ways of doing the path, if it has its own essence created by the Catholic religion, in that case, reducing the role of faith in El Camino to a mere subjective impulse is depriving it of its genuine value, is distorting it, and in the end, making it impenetrable for ourselves. It is traveling a path rejecting the sublime and concrete end to which is called. It is equating faith to any strange motivation, touristic, sport-like, or recreational. This is about treating things for what they are. El Camino has a special identity with natural and supernatural traces that we must know, not only to do it right, but to respect it and love it properly. I don't know if that helps. I hope it does. I must confess that I knew very little about El Camino before I went to it, but it so happened that I did it not with that myth. I had recently become baptized in the Catholic faith, and it seemed to me the right thing to do. I walked for 5 days. I went alone. I prayed along the way. I reflected on my own new path and what God wanted. I did it mainly to listen to what is that God wants from me now. I can't tell you how to do your path. In that sense only, I would agree with the initial premise of each one has his own path in this life, pointing to our subjectivity, but that is as far as I will go, because you and I are not alone, friend, and luckily we are not the last and ultimate thing in this world. We are not alone historically nor spiritually. There is a bigger realm of things. God inhabits it. He's never far from our hearts. If you walk El Camino, remember that it existed long before you and I, and hopefully will exist after we are gone. It is an incredible gift given by the Catholic world. Where else can you safely play drifter in this structured world? Where else can you go through such beautiful landscapes? Where else can you be surrounded by such benevolent people who are bent towards hospitality? Where else can you be on a path based on this sacred for 12 centuries? So if you're thinking of doing it, and if you had the belief of it is just about me when you started watching this, please consider a different paradigm with more transcendence. It would be a good place to start walking. For instance, El Camino is outside of you. It leads to the Apostle James. It has been cared and sanctified through centuries. There is a mass for you waiting in Santiago. There is kindness of all kinds along the way, springing from centuries of Christian values. There are gifts of the path, mysteries for you to unpack. None of that has to do with your internal self. True, you'll need enough self to establish a relationship with it and receive these gifts properly. Well, thanks for listening and watching this. I hope this helps, and let me know what you think. It is a very interesting topic. Hope you have a great day. And let me know what you think. Bye.